Okay, rich guy. I love it that you're twice as old as my grandfather and you're fat and bald.
That's enough! I've had it with you, super frat.
You've upset your mother. I've got half a mind to beat you.
Half a mind is right. Suddenly he realizes.
I can't believe you, you little monster. We'll deal with you when we get back from our honeymoon. Next.
Why'd you marry that phony? What is wrong with you? I can't believe this.
You must be the Hopkins boy.
Where'd you come from?
We've been expecting you. Welcome to Bullworth Academy. I'm sure you'll be very happy here. Very happy indeed. Anyway, I can't spend my life waiting around for naughty little boys. I've got a man to make happy. The headmaster is expecting you, Hopkins, in his study.
Okay.
His study is over there, boy, in the main building. Don't keep Dr. Cravelstitch waiting. He's a brilliant man.
Brilliant.
My friend, I only there he is! Out of here!
See you whenever. See you, Bob. Okay, see you.
See you. I hope I'm doing this right.
Later.
Here's what time it is! Yep! Time for a beatdown!
Get the new kid! Beat him down!
And don't ask how I'm doing. I've been here 5 minutes, and already people want me dead. Even my parents didn't hate me this quickly.
Well, welcome to Bullworth.
It's a dump. Great. I've been expelled from anywhere halfway decent.
Yeah, I've been expelled from anywhere halfway decent, because I'm really bad.
Give up the tough guy act, pal.
Hey, man, what's your problem?
Well, ADD primarily, but also life, my parents, the school, Western civilization, but really, honestly, enough about me.
Oh. I see you've met the dorm's mascot. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you Femboy, the girliest boy in school.
Petey, haven't you got some imaginary friends to go annoy?
Why don't you leave me alone, Gary?
Look at you. Leave me alone, Gary. I'm really self-important now that I finally hit puberty. What's your problem? I'm just being nice to the new kid as he passes through Bullworth on his inevitable journey to prison.
Look, I gotta unpack. Would you guys mind getting out of here?
Oh, now look what you've done, Pete.
Jimmy can't stand you already.
Thank you.
Okay, here's the deal. Over there, we got the nerds. Of course, they're complete social outcasts.
They look pretty harmless.
They're actually sneaky bastards. Their turf is the library. And those are the preps. They're all money and condescending attitude.
Yeah, massively inbred and completely brainless.
Very observant, Jimmy boy. Now over there are the greasers. They think they're tough.
Or at least try to look tough.
Wouldn't advise messing with them. At least not yet. They hang by the auto shop. And last but not least, the jocks. These guys rule the school. Definitely avoid them.
Whatever, I'm not afraid of some dumb roid monkeys.
You'll learn. Come on, go.
You're here to learn, not to goof off. Get to class.
Thank you. You can count on Jimmy.
Kid, huh? Everyone's talking about you.
Who are they? And what are they saying?
Nothing. Just that you're friends with the sociopath Gary.
Socio what?
Sociopath. It means... Never mind. Forget I said anything. I need you to help me.
Wait, you need me to help you?
I've got some library books that need to be returned, but I'm too scared to go to my locker.
Do I look like a librarian?
No, listen. I need your help. Pretend we're friends. Walk with me. I'll pay you $2.
$2? Are you crazy? Make it $5.
No. $2?
Great. $5. Let's go, buddy.
Okay.